Well, Birdsworth, won't be long now, will it? Your old mate Bryant will soon be in here to give you all the sordid details about how Kent and Daniels died.
You must have heard the noises too.
What? Oh, yes, it seemed to be coming from in there. I thought I'd better take a quick look.
Oh, it was probably me you heard crashing about. Oh. I nearly got one of them.
One? What are you talking about?
Rats.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think there's a family in there. I saw one. Huge, big animal. Oh, teeth like razor blades.
Oh, teeth.
Do you want to help me track him down?
Oh, no, thanks. No, prisoners I sometimes know about, but rats, well, I'll leave that to the experts. Oh, no offence.
It's right in mine. Get in there. Get her to bed, Mason, and get her sobered up.
How did you like that one?
Let's try and be quiet, Lizzie.
Hey, look what I got.
Ah,
I was as hungry as sailors when I...
Is everything all right, Miss Ferguson?
Yes, Mrs. Barry. Birdsworth was, she was having a nightmare.
Oh, dear, do you think I should...
Oh, no, I wouldn't wake her now. She'll be all right. She, said that she dreamt she was drunk.
Well, yes, that's what I heard. Oh, you know, she's probably upset about Smith. They were very close. I don't know. What with rats and Lizzie making all that racket, it's a wonder the whole prison isn't awake.
Yes. Well, look, why don't we go and have a cup of coffee?
Oh, good.
I don't think there'll be any more disturbances tonight. Should all be quiet now till the morning.
Yeah.
Another likely contender is the prisoner we're getting from Barnhurst.
Oh, terrific. Anyone we know?
Cass Parker. She was serving a term for manslaughter until she killed an officer. So be very careful.
Ah, Hunt. I've got a little job for you.
What's that, Miss Ferguson?
You're going to pay a visit on the women after lights out.
How am I going to do that?
Oh, I'll let you in. Then it's up to you to wake them and have a little chat. Remind them that their top dog has gone and they need protection.
Protection against what?
Just $2 a week, Hunt. That's cheap rates for health benefits. They'll love it.
Some of the women haven't got much cash, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, and I've made allowances for that, Hunt. There are other things they can do. Like inform on anyone who's against Stevens.
Geez, I don't think anyone will lag, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, they will. Smith's reign is over, Hunt. There are new rules now, and you're going to help see that they're obeyed, aren't you?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Good. Now, I've paved the way for you. There shouldn't be any trouble.
What about that new Sheila? She looks tough.
Ugh, she's as thick as two planks. You won't get any trouble there. From now on, Hunt, it's smooth sailing all the way.
Watch out for my arm.
Listen to me. A little birdie has told me that you two are trying to set up Parker as top dog.
I don't know what you're on about. Somebody's been feeding you with a load of rubbish.
Don't be so sure. But just remember, I call the shots around here. and you'll take orders from Stevens as long as it suits me.
It's not going to last forever.
Oh, yes, it will. So it's a waste of time chatting up Parker. Besides, we can't have a screw killer to represent the women. Even Mrs. Bleeding Heart Morris wouldn't listen to a screw killer. Now move.
That's right, Bryant. Nice and neat. You're not in that flop house now, are you? You're home. Isn't that right? Answer me, Bryant.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
You know, killing Kent off like that isn't going to make you too popular with the other women. But I'm sure Smith will understand. Do you think Smith will understand, Bryant?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Good. Then why don't you write and tell her? At Barnhurst.
You're lying. You're lying. You're a liar. You're lying. You're lying. You're lying.
How much of a threat is Parker?
No threat. Come on, she's so thick she wouldn't even know how to break bread.
Maybe. But if someone with brains were to get behind her, she could be a big help to both of us. Look, keep an eye on Bryant. Let me know where she stands. We can talk to Parker later.
Parker, get over against that wall.
Hey, how's Phyllis? She's all right, isn't she?
Yeah, of course she's all right.
With all that blood.
Trouble is, Cass, you need someone to look after you to stop you being locked away in here.
Oh, I heard her. I know I did.
We'd be happy to help you.
She shouldn't have said all them rotten things, and I should
have... Will you stop worrying about Phyllis? We used her to set you up.
Well, why would you do that?
Well, we heard about your reputation, Parker. Just wanted to see it at first hand before we took you on the team.
You mean... you got me to bash someone just to see if I could?
You did a good job too, Cass. You're just the kind of person we need to run our rackets.
Quick, get out!
You mongrels! You dirty rotten mongrels! You come back here! I'll show what it's like being bashed! You dirty rotten mongrels!
And I thought we could talk her around to our way of thinking.
Solitary will soften her up.
Close, she almost killed us.
Trouble is, she hasn't got the brains to know when to use her muscle to advantage. A little guiding hand by the right person is what's needed.
And you're volunteering?
If I think it's necessary.
Well, I think it's unwise. Her temper can't be trusted. Any provocation, she could turn on us.
Not losing your nerve, are you? Maybe I should put by a little insurance.
Come on, get to the point.
Our little rackets, we're doing nicely, aren't we?
So?
So I want a fair share.
I wondered how long it would take you. Well, the cut stays the same, 50-50, straight down the middle.
That's not enough.
That's all you're getting.
You listen to me, Stevens. You may think you've got it over the other women, but you are no match for me. 60-40 or nothing.
Then it's nothing. I don't need you anymore.
You just made a very dangerous decision, Stevens. Interesting to see how you get by without my protection.
But you just said yourself, I already have the women on my side.
We'll see about that, Stevens. Forget Stevens. She's out of the game. Don't start asking questions because you won't get any answers. All you need to know is that I'm giving the orders now. Do I make myself clear?
Yeah. But don't expect me to go near that Cass Parker dame again.
You'll do as you're told. Because if you don't, I'll be in charge of the beating next time, and you won't be so lucky. You still haven't learned, have you, Stevens?
We're really wasting our energies. I think we'd work much better together.
agreed.
With a 60-40 cut in my favour.
There's no choice, is there?
What's your hurry, huh? I didn't want to keep you waiting. Lizzie said you wanted to see me.
Did she now? And did she happen to say where?
Yeah, in the shower block.
Well, then that's where you better go, isn't it?
What for?
I'd say that Birdsworth was setting you up, Hunt. But what we have to find out is why. Where was Parker when she spoke to you?
Well, she wasn't in the rec room.
Then I'd say it's Parker who wants to see you. You better not keep her waiting.
And Parker, you've got to be kidding. She'll kill me.
Oh, no. If anyone gets hurt this time, it'll be Parker. Now, you stall her. Understand?
Yeah.
Okay. Get moving.
Look, I don't like hurting people, Phyllis.
Oh, neither do I, Cass. I reckon you and I have got a lot in common. I reckon we should talk about it, don't you?
Yeah, that'd be real nice, but I've got to be quick.
Look, I didn't want to do those things. Sonia made me do them. She would have got me if I hadn't.
I don't want to hurt you,
Cass. Cass, Miss Ferguson!
I wasn't doing nothing.
Hold on.
I'm not going no place, Miss Ferguson.
I know you're not. You've got a lot to learn, Parker.
Me?
Here. First, Parker, never kill a screw. Because there's always a lot of other screws just waiting to teach you a lesson. Like this.
Get up, Harvey! Oh, Jesus! And use your feet! No, do that screw! Okay, Parker,
that's enough. Stop! Oh, now stop it. Go on. Stand over there while you calm down. Oh, there's a good girl. You all right, dear?
I'll get you, Parker. I'm finished with you.
Now, son of a bat talk. You just stay there to get your breath back. Why, you love?
They just wouldn't stop me, and Miss Ferguson kept throwing me out, and they kept coming, I wouldn't stop.
Oh, no, dear, Miss Ferguson wouldn't do anything like that. She's here to look after us. Why don't you go and lie down for a while? Have a little rest. Go on, go on. Off you go. Well, well, you lot of amateurs aren't a pretty sight. Three against one and look at you.
Amateurs be back and she fights like a threat.
She fights like a winner, dear. And as far as I'm concerned, that's the only thing to do. Now, take your friends to the doctor.
Get out.
Now, if you think it's necessary to report this, I think you should leave Cass's name right out of it. Just say you found those three all beaten up.
Are you pushing your luck, Donovan?
If you don't, Miss Ferguson, I shall have to tell Mrs. Reynolds exactly what I saw. Three people holding Cass while you hit her.
She wouldn't believe you.
Well, of course she would. After all, who'd believe that one person could beat those three lumps and a fine, strapping girl like you? Just couldn't be done. And besides, Mrs. Reynolds and I go back a long way. Think it over, dear.
And what about Harvey and Hunt? All right, well, do whatever you think best. Thanks, Scott. Adler's been sent to Wentworth General with suspected internal injuries.
And the other two?
Oh, badly bruised, but nothing to worry about. Have you questioned them?
Yeah. Not much luck, though. They won't lag on their mates.
Some mates. What about the rest of the women?
Same story. I think they're all related to the three wise monkeys.
But it must have been quite a fight. No black eyes or blood noses to be seen.
No, nothing.
Well, either they were the only two fighting, or we've got another one of those damn mysteries on our hands.
What's your hurry, Stevens?
You got something better than lunch offering?
Just went to Hunt's cell to check the numbers book.
So?
Hunt's figures for the last take. It seems that my cut was only 25%. Big difference to the 60% we agreed on, don't you think?
Well, there must be some mistake.
Oh, there's been a mistake, all right, Stevens, and you made it. You honestly don't think you're going to get away with that, do you?
Look, I'm sure we can straighten it out.
Oh, we'll straighten it out, all right. From now on, I take all the money. I pay the expenses and you get a cut. Understood? Understood?
Now, the minute I get her talking, make sure you press that record button.
All right, what do you think I am, dumb or something?
Shh, she's coming. Miss Ferguson, this brush seems to have had it. Could you organise me with another one?
It'll last the day.
I think Donovan's bringing the booze in today. Well, don't worry about her. She can't hear a thing when she's plugged in. Did you find out who Donovan's visitor was yesterday?
Yeah, just a solicitor.
She probably asked him to set it up. You know, if she goes through with it, it'll be the finish of our business.
You don't seem to have very much confidence in me, Stevens. If I can get rid of Smith, I really don't see how Donovan can be a challenge.
It's not a matter of confidence, Miss Ferguson. You're getting a major cut in this partnership. I figure it's time you earned it.
If you didn't have my protection, Stevens, you'd be out of business in 5 minutes, and you know it.
These are clear to go.
Right, can I help you?
Yes, I wonder if I could see Mrs. Donovan. I rang earlier.
Yeah, you must be Mr. Dorsey. Look, if you just sign in over here, I'll organise it for you.
Look, I'll see Mr. Dorsey through, if you like. You'll find Donovan in the laundry.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson. You're most helpful.
A friend of the family, are you?
Oh, I've known them for a long time.
Ah, well, let's not keep Mrs. Donovan waiting.
Told me how things stand.
All these things take time. He's doing what he can, dear. We just have to be patient.
Yeah.
Time's up, Donovan.
Well, you don't get very long.
No, dear, but they're very nice to us on the whole. Well, bye-bye, dear. Come again.
No physical contact. Officer Radcliffe, I'll see you out.
I see what you mean. Very helpful, too.
OK, Donovan, hand it over.
Pardon?
Let's just call it a routine search, shall we? Well, I don't think the governor's going to be too pleased with her old friend, is she? And I shouldn't imagine the other women will be too happy with you either.
I want a word with you. Well, you're not quite as clever as you thought you were, are you?
Just keep your voice down. Now, what the hell are you on about, Stevens?
Donovan's handed out the scotch.
Rubbish, I confiscated it.
Just as she planned, probably already had the supply.
How the hell would she have got it in here?
Think again, Ferguson. She's just handed it out. Well, losing your touch, boss lady. Well, you've just earned yourself a demotion. From now on, you bring the supplies in from the outside and I'll make sure there aren't any more slip-ups.
Don't you push me too far, Stevens.
I don't think I need to push you at all. In fact, I think you'd be quite happy to do as I say. We're getting a major cut in this partnership. I figure it's time to end it.
If you didn't have my protection, Stevens, you'd be out of business in 5 minutes and you know it.
And of course, there's more than that.
Just how far did you think you'd get with this, Stevens?
Think of you ruining it. Never mind, I've got some more copies. So you do as I say. Or else one of the tapes goes to the governor, and another one just like it to the department. Do we have a deal, Ferguson?
All right, Mitchell, where is it? Get those things off. I want the tape. Don't play silly buggers with me, Mitchell. I want what you taped in the corridor this morning.
Why don't you ask Sonia for it?
That was a copy. I want the original.
I haven't got it. She took it to make copies. I haven't got it, I tell you.
You're lying to me, Mitchell.
What are you doing to the poor girl?
It's none of your business, Donovan. And if I were you, I wouldn't try that smuggling trick again because it won't work a second time.
Oh, really?
Maybe you've got a weak heart like Birdsworth. Perhaps we should put it to the test.
keep. And when I get through with a lot of you, your lives won't be worth living.
Stevens. I've been thinking over that little proposition of yours. There's no way I'm going to risk my neck bringing things in here for you.
Perhaps it's time for me to use the tape.
Look, the best I can do is turn a blind eye at visiting time if you've got someone to bring the stuff in.
Well, if that's the only option, I'd better take it. But I need to use the phone right now if I want to get things moving. Otherwise, Minnie Donovan is going to take over.
Not while I'm alive.
Hey, see, Minnie, I'm a winner too.
You thieving bitch.
Give her one.
Okay, break it up, you two.
She took my pen.
I was only doing what she told me to.
Well, Donovan, been doing a bit of tutoring, have you? All right, you lot, the party's over. Get back to your cells.
Oh, come on, the bell hasn't even gone
yet. I said get moving.
Why, you and your bloody bright ideas.
Mitchell, any more of that mouth and you'll be on a charge.
Take it easy, Miss Ferguson, or Mrs. Reynolds might get to hear a very interesting little message on tape.
Wait there, Donovan. Get out, Parker. I said get out. All right, Donovan, give me the tape.
I haven't got it on me, have I, dear?
Where is it?
In the door.
Don't fool with me, Donovan. I've just looked there.
That's why I figured it was safe to put it back.
You better not be lying to me, Donovan. Now move. Out, Mitchell.
What do I do now?
I said get out. Find the tape, Donovan.
Oh, I've got to think. I've had to move it so often. Oh, no, I put it in that cupboard before the search. Oh!
Now you find it, or you get more of the same.
Don't do it. It's not worth the trouble you'll get into.
Back off, Parker.
You hit me. I'm going to fix you.
I said back off or she gets more of the same.
Don't you hurt her.
It's up to you, Parker. Now let me get to that door. Tell her.
Do it, Cass. Do it, she says.
Through with you yet, Donovan? Now, while ever you've got that tape.
She would have killed you, Min.
She would have.
Don't you worry, dear. The likes of her's not going to get the better of me.
What do you want?
Thought you might be lonely.
Well, I'm not. So why don't you nick off?
You're pushing your luck, Mitchell.
If you lay a finger on me, I'll let everyone know about it. The governor, the lot of them.
You're not being very sensible. It's about time you learned a little respect for authority.
What are you going to do?
Me? Oh, I'm not going to do anything, Mitchell. But you, you're going to be the victim of a savage bashing. By person or persons unknown. Now, you remember that, Bobby? That is the important part.
Get in here. She's all yours.
Please, please, leave me.
Give you a hand.
Oh.
Oh. Yeah, I know. Come, easy does it. That's the way. And you better lie down on your bed. Jeez, what rotten mungle done this to you?
Maybe we should ask you that, Parker.
Me? Oh, no, I just found her.
I'd say you just bashed her.
No, honest.
It's your style, isn't it? A good bashing. What you do, get on the wrong side of your temper.
Miss Ferguson.
Shut up. This has got your trademark all over it. All right, Mitchell. Now, you've got nothing to fear as long as you cooperate. Who did this to you, Mitchell?
Harker. Harker, done it. Bobby.
Right, Parker. Now we talk.
You found Mitchell, did you, Miss Ferguson?
That's right.
And you honestly believe her story about what happened?
Why do you ask?
Her injuries are not consistent with a fall down a flight of stairs.
She didn't go into any detail, but I did find her at the bottom of the stairs and saw no reason to disbelieve her.
You know, it's a remarkable coincidence that you happen to be on the spot every time someone gets hurt around here.
What are you suggesting?
Just that you might know more about these accidents than we hear.
Doctor, I would suggest that you stick to medicine. Your imagination isn't sharp enough to start writing whodunits. The report, if you don't mind. I've got a very busy schedule.
Well, I'm sorry to have wasted your time. There are one or two aspects I'd like to discuss with the governor. So I'll be taking it to her myself.
That's awful, Min. Little Bobby's been bashed. Something dreadful. And I didn't do it, Min. Honest, I didn't. She told Miss Ferguson I did.
Well, why would you do that? Well, obviously, Mrs. Reynolds doesn't believe her, or you'd be in the pound right now.
She never took me to the gut.
Yeah, well, it smells like something the freak had set up. Did she do the bashing?
Oh, poor little Bobby. Well, why would Miss Ferguson want to beat him up?
Now, come on, Cass. There's something you're not telling us, isn't there? Why didn't she take you to the governor?
She wanted that tape, Min. Well, I had to let her have it. She was going to do terrible things. No, not to me, to you and little Bobby.
You mean there was something on that tape about Ferguson?
Tape for the broadcast tonight?
Oh, no, it actually belongs to a friend of mine. It got mangled in the cassette player when she was driving me to work this morning.
Hope it's not one of her favourites.
Oh, well, as a matter of fact, it is, and I was going to try and fix it for her.
Not much point. Even if you do get it untwisted, the sound will be distorted.
Oh. Well, at least I'll know what to buy her for her birthday.
Found any good tapes lately?
Just lowering the odds. Wouldn't want anything to interfere with our business dealings, would we?
Of course not, Miss Ferguson.
I wonder if the nice lady would be so cocky if she knew about the other one.
Now, what can you tell us about this tape?
That tape would have given you all you need to know about Ferguson. Not only is she involved right up to her neck in every racket in the prison, but I can tell you things about her that'll make your hair curl. Well, Sonia has a copy, I'm positive of it.
Does she?
It'd be in the interests of all of us if you could get that other tape, Mrs. Reynolds. And it'd certainly help drive a big, hefty nail into Ferguson's coffin.
Oh, I understand why you want the tape, Mrs. Reynolds. But in here, everything has a price on it.
I'd call that blackmail.
I call it insurance. Insurance that everybody gets what they deserve after the transaction.
You're wasting your time, Stevens. I'll pull this place apart until I find it.
What makes you think it's in the prison?
Good afternoon.
Yes, well, it could be for some of us. Mr. Harnsworth is waiting to see you in the governor's office.
See me? He's come all this way to see me. Must be important.
Apparently. Something to do with a certain tape.
What could that possibly have to do with me?
Don't keep him waiting.
It's quite clear, Governor. You've been sold a bill of goods.
Have I, Miss Ferguson?
These allegations are ridiculous.
A lot of the women are prepared to substantiate them.
Oh, I'm sure they are. But it doesn't mean they're true, does it?
You may be right, Miss Ferguson, but we do have to go through the motions nevertheless.
Yes, well, with all due respect, sir, you do have to understand these women. They don't take too kindly to an officer who expects them to stick to the rules.
Explain that.
Well, now, Stevens, for instance. She's just had a loss of privileges for her involvement in a gambling and illicit alcohol racket. Well, of course she's going to try and get back at me.
All right, Miss Ferguson, we realize prisoners do try to retaliate. But how do you explain this?
Ah, yes, young Mitchell's tape. She fell down the stairs, sir, and in the process damaged the tape. I thought I might be able to fix it for her.
Well, that's an admirable sentiment.
I see. Where's the missing tape, then?
Oh, I didn't know that it was missing. It was certainly in there when I left the staff room. Mrs. Morris can tell you that.
Come in. Thank you, Miss Riley. Now, Stevens, your requests will be granted in return for the tape you told me about. Did you bring it with you?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, I don't know what you're talking about.
Would you prefer to speak to us alone, Stevens?
About that tape you mentioned?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, but I don't know about any tape that could help you.
You'd better have a good reason for that little charade in the governor's office, or you won't be looking quite so smug when I'm finished with you.
But of course I have. But you must admit I'd be better off without you.
Oh, nice try. What went wrong?
I changed my mind. It's better the devil you know than the devil you don't.
Oh, come on, Stevens. I can't imagine you passing up a chance to get out of here. Not unless something went wrong. And I'm prepared to buy it. For now. So you just watch yourself in the future, Stevens. Any more clever tricks and you'll be selling tickets to your own funeral. And get that stuff into the laundry.
Well, didn't you? Well, you can put it in the bag till tomorrow.
Running off at the mouth again, Donovan? You've been doing a lot of that lately, haven't you? And it's all been a waste of time. Ladies, you'll all be thrilled to know that I am going to be around for a long time yet. It didn't work, ladies. You're going to have to try a hell of a lot harder than that to beat me at my game. Now get out of here, the lot of you.
Joan Ferguson?
Yeah, that's right.
I think we have some business to discuss, Miss Ferguson.
I doubt that very much.
Oh, I think you'll be very interested. It's a little matter of security. An investment for the future, if you like. What do you say?
You've been a very busy lady, Miss Ferguson. Not exactly what the Department of Corrective Services had in mind, eh?
Look, why don't you just name your price and let's get this over with?
Well, let's see. What price would you put on your career, Miss Ferguson? 40,000? 50?
You're out of your mind.
Not me, lady. I think cool and straight. I'm a reasonable man. Let's not be greedy. $10,000, and you can have this little number as a souvenir for your glory box. Uh-uh. You get the tape when I get the money.
What's to stop you making copies and bleeding me dry for the rest of my life?
Not a thing. You're just going to have to trust me, aren't you?
You don't leave me much choice, do you?
That's right.
Well, you'd have to give me time. I haven't got that sort of money. I have to raise it somehow.
There's no hurry. Just so long as I get 10,000 in 48 hours.
You want the tape back?
Oh, don't you worry. I'll get it back. But your little friend had better not count on making any copies of it. Because if I don't get him, Stevens, I'll kill you. And that is a promise.
He's coming.
Yeah.
Bobby? You didn't have the guts to finish Ferguson, so we're doing it for you.
Where are they now? What's happening?
You're too late. It's all over by now.
Oh, my God.
Hurry up, Pixie. Now get the knife out. That's right, and open it. Now open it, Pixie. Go over and cut the sheet. Cut the sheet, Pixie!
I wonder if you'd allow me to present this for next month's medical journal, Miss Ferguson. Oh. Well, let me explain. By rights, these vertebrae should have been severely damaged. But fortunately for you, the muscle structure of your neck is extremely strong. Well, there's still damage, of course, but nothing we can't take care of.
When can I get out?
Well, we won't worry about that for a while, will we?
I have to. I have to get back to work.
Now, come on. You really must be sensible. Statistically, you shouldn't even be alive. Now, you just rest and leave everything to us. If you need anything, give nurse a buzz. All right? You're being very foolish. I can't be held responsible if you don't take treatment.
Good. You're off the hook, then. Do I have to sign out?
Miss Ferguson, please. You do have some ligament damage. And I'm still not sure how your larynx will react after treatment. You need at least 3 days in traction.
Listen, if you want to see me, I'll be back in a couple of days. Right now, I've got things to do.
Fixed. Sorry to keep you waiting, Miss Ferguson.
How long is this going to take?
2 more signatures, that's all. Now, you do understand about the caveat on your house?
Just show me where to sign.
Yes, of course. There you are. Just sign next to the crosses.
Money. Where's the money?
No worries there. Everything's been cleared, so you'll have the check in your hand in 30 minutes.
I want cash, please.
Miss Ferguson, $10,000 is a lot of money.
24% is a lot of interest. Now, do I sign these or not?
Yes, of course. If you'll excuse me, I'll get the accountant to draw on the check. It won't be a moment.
Yep. Who? I can't hear you.
Joan Ferguson.
Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to ring you all day.
Getting the money. Now bring the tape over and I'll give it to you.
Don't be stupid, Ferguson. You bring it.
I can't, Baxter. I'm not well.
Well, tough lady. If you want that tape, you come here for it. I'm not walking into a house full of cops with a thing like that in my pocket.
All right. Where do you live?
A taxi will pick you up. You wait.
Stop.